Hi children, how are you all? Are you all fine? Yes, I hope you all are fine and well. Okay, so let's come on our topic, our main course book, that chapter number 8, Candice and Professor Google. Today, we are going to learn from our main course book, chapter number 8, Candice and Professor Google. So, it is one kind of magical story. Mice. You can say mice are there. That mice are the stories that is based on some tradition and some customs and some rules and regulations of earlier time. Okay, so it is related to some heroic work. Adventures related to some gods, goddess, and that in earlier societies and earlier tradition rules. So that mythical stories are there. They are related to that kind of things of earlier things. So many popular stories are there from the Greek. The Greek have great mythology. Great mythological stories are there in Greek. So, that today, the story Candice and Professor Google is a one story is about a small girl, Candice. She was just 11 years old. That Candice, that girl is there, small. She was just 11 years old. That story we will see now. So here, that Candice is there. She was just a little girl of 11 years old. And you know that she always got into trouble. That small girl is there, Candice. She always put into trouble. Always facing different kind of troubles. Sometimes great trouble, sometimes small trouble. So she was always facing means difficulties and some troubles, and her habit is there to ask questions till when that another person can tire to give answer of her questions. That much time she will ask questions. In short, she was a very curious girl. She wanted to know lot many things, new ideas, new things, what is there, who are there, that all thing she wanted to know. In short, that Candice, she was very curious girl and she had a habit to ask questions till when she got satisfied answer from other person. So we'll see. Candice had one old neighbor. In neighbor of that Candice's house, one old person was living. He was Candice's neighbor, Professor Google. Professor Google was a gardener and he loves to read books. So all are telling him Professor Google because he likes to read. That's why all are saying him Professor Google. Okay. One day, that Candice was playing, and when she was playing, her father said to her, "Candice, you are a Pandora's box. You are a Pandora's box." So Candice was confused. That what is Pandora's box? I am neither Pandora. Neither Pandora nor a box. Candice's father told her that you are like a Pandora's box. So Candice replied to her father that I am neither a Pandora nor a box. Then what is Pandora's box? So her father was confused and roared and angry. So father said, "Why are you asking me these questions? What are you doing?" Then that girl left that house and went to the neighbor, said, "Professor Google." She has gone to the Professor Google. She was shouting, "Professor Google, Professor Google, Professor Google, Professor Google, where are you?" Then she met with that Professor Google and asked her, "Hey, what is Pandora's box? Explain." "So my father told me Pandora box to me. So I would like to know what is Pandora's box." So Professor looked at that girl, Candice, and smiled. "Yes, come here, beta, and sit with me. I will tell you what is Pandora's box." So this way, Professor called that girl with him, and the girl was sitting with that professor, and professor was reading books in his garden, and the girl went. Professor called that girl and make her sit with him, and his introducing what is called Pandora's box. Okay, so for that he is telling one story. Professor Google said to girl, "I am going to tell you one story. Then from the story you will understand what is called Pandora's box. Means what is the meaning of Pandora's box?" So professor is telling story. Many centuries ago, that Greek people believed that gods were like men. Gods were like men, looking like men, but very stronger than men. Gods were like men, but they were looking very stronger than men. They can change the shape, means they can disguise also. They can take outlook like animal. Then you know, mortal man, birds, any plants, monsters, anyone's shape they can take. Means in short, they can change themselves in these all things. So that gods were there. That powerful god was that Zeus. Zeus was the powerful of all gods in earlier times. One day that he was angry. Zeus was angry because why he was angry? He was angry because they used a fire, and that fire was stolen from the Zeus by another god. Then Zeus was angry. The god Zeus was angry. Why? Because another god was there. He had stolen fire from Zeus. So the Zeus was angry. So he decided to send a woman on the earth. He ordered to create a woman and send that woman on the earth. Okay? So as per his order, a woman was created, and she was with the many qualities. The woman which was made, she got many qualities, and she was sent on the earth with one box. Woman which was created by God, she got many qualities, and with many qualities she was sent to the earth with one box. Like that Pandora, that woman was also very curious. She was also very curious to know about what was there in box. First of all, that woman was there. She controlled herself and controlled her curiosity, but after some time her curiosity broke and she wanted to know that what was there in the box? What was given in the box? She opened that box. In her curiosity, she opened that box. And there come some evil things from that box. So many wrong things came out from the box on the earth. And it is said that all evil spread in the all over the world from that box only. It is said that the bottom part is left, the box only. Hope remains that there is something good in the bottom of that box. So Pandora's box means to invite difficulties. Professor Google explained to that Canadian girl that Pandora's box means to invite difficulties, that to keep ourselves in difficulty. That is meaning of Pandora's box. So why did my father told me Pandora box to me? That small girl raised one question to that Professor Google. In short, can we then raise question to Professor Google? Why my father told me Pandora's box? Am I creating problem? No. Then why my father told me Pandora's box? So well, here little girl, you are always asking questions, and anyone don't know what will happen next to you and what you will do next. So your father told her Pandora's box because you always create problem and keep yourself in difficulty. So your father told you Pandora's box means you kept yourself and with another person in difficulty. In short, that you yourself also keep you in difficulty and the other person also will be in difficulty. Means whenever you will not get right answer, that much time you will ask questions. So Pandora's box means to invite difficulties, and you always keep create troubles for others and for yourself also. So your father told you Pandora's box. Okay, what is going to happen next to you that anyone don't know? Anyone don't know what is going to happen next to you because you are that much curious and always creating problem. So all are confused what will happen next. So your father told you Pandora's box. Okay, now I understand that small girl Candy Jane, she said, now I understand why my father told me Pandora's box, because that girl always create problems for others and for herself also. So you get into trouble, that is the main point means to tell you a Pandora's box. That all kind of troubles you are inviting, so only your father told you that you are Pandora's box. Okay, that girl is now very much curious to know about that Pandora's box. So she is asking question to Professor Google that, Professor, can you tell me another story about this? Do you have story like this, more stories like that Pandora's box? Can you tell me one more story like Pandora's box? So that Professor Google saying, yes, I have one more story that I am going to tell you about Pandora's box, and you will have to find out your own. Now Professor Google said, I will tell you one story, but other stories you will have to find yourself. Okay. Professor Google said, long time ago, many years before. One king was living in one kingdom and his name was Midas. Midas. He was praying to God for a long time. That king Midas prayed to the God for a long time. God appeared him and asked for peace. Then king said, "Oh God, grant me peace. Whatever thing I will touch, it will change into gold." Because that king was very greedy. King was very greedy. When the God appeared him, God asked, "What do you want? Ask me this." Then when God asked him for this, he said, "Grant me a wish. Whatever thing I will touch, it will change into gold." So God said, "Okay, your wish will complete." And then from the day he got wish, whatever thing he was touching, that all things changing, all things were changing into gold. Even he was touching his palace, wall, bricks, comb, spoon, even food. Whatever food he was eating, that food he was whenever touching in his plate, immediately that plate changed into gold. Food, rice, dal, chapatis, whatever he was touching, that all thing changing into gold. And he was unable to eat that food because as per the feast of that as per the bones, that feast of his wish was there, that his wish was there, that anyone he will touch or anything he will touch, it will change into gold. So as per his wish, all things, whatever he was touching, changing into gold. In a short period of time, many things he touched and all changed into gold. Even his food, water, juice, everything changed into gold. One day, when he was sitting, his favorite daughter came to the king, and a small daughter touched the king, and immediately what happened? That Candy Jane asked to Professor Google, that king was touching to anything, it was changing into gold. But the daughter touched herself to the king, then what happened? Professor Google said, the same process happened. King touching to the daughter or daughter touched to the king, same thing. The daughter definitely changed into gold. Then, when his own daughter changed into gold, he was very sad. He again prayed to that God, and again God appeared him and asked for this. And Midas said, Midas joined his two hands to the God and said, "Please take my this wish back. I don't want this wish." So God said him, "You can go in the river and wash yourself," means bath in the river, that Pactolus river, you can go and bath, and your that magic power will wash away with water. So same thing that he done, he went to the river and bath in the river, and with his bath, his all that power was there, it was washed away in the water of river. So all power washed. Now king had no wish. His wish was not continuing. His all wish washed away in water. So whatever thing he touched with his hand and whatever changed into coal, it again changed in its original same. Means his food happened food, his daughter changed into his daughter only. When it was changed into gold, that daughter was there of king. She was changed into gold and again she was alive. And king went at home and met his daughter. And it was a nice story that King Midas wish was there to come to change, to touch anything and change into gold. And at last he left this wish because it was that wish was only that dangerous thing for him. So, okay. Now, Professor Mughal saying, that's why your father told you Pandora's box, that mice are the story. From that story, stories based on some tradition about society, we can learn many messages, many unknown things we can learn from mice. In short, mice gives us life messages and some important things. It teaches us values of life, and that's why we need to listen to mice. And Professor Mughal told that girl Candyman that now your duty is there, go in the library and search about the book Aeschylus and Herculean Epos, and one more book is there that what as Hex. These three books get and find the stories from these books. So this way you will also get some mice and you can learn the stories and learn about the life messages which are very useful in our life. So this is a nice story about Candyman and Professor Mughal. I hope you understand it well. Okay, thank you children. Bye.